Devontae and Mount News. Devontae.
Thank you.
Good morning and welcome to the 2007 Special Needs Graduation. It is now my pleasure to introduce the principal of Eisenhower Middle School, Ms. Nicole Poncari.
Good morning. I'd like to welcome everyone to our graduation today. It's a very special day, and we are so excited to see all of you here. I would like to start by introducing some guests we have with us today. We have Dr. Bill Dura, our Director of People Services, Mrs. Terry Johnson, our former Special Education Supervisor, and we have with us also Dr. Beth Marvin, our current Special Education Supervisor. We are very happy to have everyone morning. I'd like to begin by asking everyone to please stand, and we're going to salute the flag. I pledge allegiance
speaker for the 2007 Special Needs Graduation, Anthony Diaz.
auditorium.
Thank you, Mrs. Dryden, for that very moving presentation. It is a visual reminder of how blessed we all are. Simply because we have known the graduates and all of our students. Now I'd like to present our musical selection, The Jazz Hunter, featuring Marcus Hadrick, one of our special needs students. Mark Ross on the sax. At this time, I'd like to ask our guests and graduates to return to their seats on stage.
I would just like to address our graduates for a moment before introducing our guest speaker. It really truly has been my pleasure thus far this morning to be able to participate in this wonderful graduation ceremony. For many of the staff at Eisenhower Middle School, including myself, it's a moment that we have mixed emotions. We are excited and very proud of our graduates to see them moving on. However, we are also sad to see them go. Many of their faces have become very familiar, either working in the office, answering the front door, and just doing many tasks around the building. We hear them having conversations and laughing, and anytime you go by, they're always there to say, you know, good morning, Miss Poincare, and we truly will miss them. I would also like to take a moment just to thank them for what they have added to Eisenhower Middle School through their vocational work, work in the cafeteria, in the office, as I said before. The graduates today that are leaving us each have a very special gift of their own. And I am very confident that as they move on to new endeavors, they will take that gift with them and touch many more lives, just as they have done at Eisenhower Middle School. And with that, I would personally like to congratulate each and every one of them on their graduation this morning. Congratulations, everyone. At this time, it's also my pleasure to be able to introduce our guest speaker today. As I said before, we have with us today Mrs. Terry Johnson. Mrs. Terry Johnson was the supervisor of special education in the Norristown Area School District for over 25 years. She's presently a special education supervisor at the Montgomery County Intermediate Unit. Terry Johnson was a familiar face to all of the special needs students as she worked closely with the students and their family. We are very excited to have her with us today as our guest speaker. I would like to introduce to you Mrs. Johnson.
Talk to, and I know this room has echoes. So can people hear me fairly well? Okay, good. I began my teaching career as a special education teacher for teens and young adults, very much like the graduates sitting here today. I so much enjoy these young people and the staff of Eisenhower that it's truly a pleasure and an honor to be invited back today for graduation. First, I'd like to congratulate our graduates, Verna, Tony, Bobby, Tommy, Gabrielle, and Sean. I'd also like to recognize the teachers and teacher assistants, Beth Marvin, Susan Wright, Teresa Henning, and all the members of the special education support staff here at Eisenhower. Through firsthand knowledge, having worked with them for many years, I can tell you their work here is not just a job and not even just a career. It's a work of devotion. I also want to give credit to the Eisenhower community, principal, faculty, and support staff who've always welcomed our special students, recognized the unique qualities in each one, and made them part of the Eisenhower family. None of this would have been possible without the members of the school board, the superintendent, Dr. Andreco, Dr. Dura, Dr. Martin, and the Norristown Area School District Committee community that had committed the school district for so many years, for so many decades now, to serving our special students in classrooms, in their own schools, as well as opening our doors to special students from neighboring school districts. But today I want to give special recognition to you, the parents, families, and friends of our graduates. You've accepted the task, and you've done the work of raising a special person. You've made the effort when you were beyond tired. You've been patient when your patience was at an end. You have found a way when there was no way and precious little support. And to borrow a line from one of my favorite TV shows, you have outwitted, outlasted, and outloved, and you've survived. I know your work is not done. There are challenges ahead that you will meet as you've met the challenges before. But you do get something back in return, something that is sadly all too rare in so many lives, but something your children, our young graduates, have in abundance. You get in return the unconditional love of your children. You get the satisfaction of knowing what you do every day matters to a very special and deserving person. You get the return of unguarded smiles, genuine laughter, as well as the example of a special person who takes what he's been given and enjoys every day. The recognition that even the small things your children learn and achieve are shared by the two of you, mother and child, father and child, brother and sister. These young graduates give you daily the joys and satisfying moments that are really what makes life worthwhile. These young adults aren't concerned about how someone looks before they make them a friend. They aren't obsessed with making $1 million, although that would be all right. They aren't consumed with perfection or with what other people might think. How much we can all learn from them if we pay attention. And that, I believe, is why I have always enjoyed their company. They remind me every day of how to live life and how to enjoy life. So I want to thank them, these graduates, for being the wonderful and special person each one of them is. I know they will take their gifts out into their next big adventure and the adventures after that, and share those gifts with whoever is lucky enough to become their friends. Congratulations, graduates. You, your teachers and assistants, your parents, grandparents, brothers and sisters have done well. Thank you.
Thank you. At this time, we are going to begin the process of awarding the diplomas to our graduates. Graduates will be stopping at the front of the stage for pictures after they receive their diplomas, if I would like to come forth and take those pictures. We would first like to call Sean Maddie. Thank you. next graduate is Tony Diaz. Okay, our next graduate coming up is Tom Jeffers. Gabriel Gomez.
Welcome to our event today for graduation. At first, I would like to assist with giving the gifts to our graduates, and then I would like to speak about one of our life skills students who is missing today.
Sean Mabel. Most of us are parents, grandparents, uncles, or aunts, and we know about taking care of children. But some of us have also unfortunately experienced the passing of a child. Today, I wanted to make you aware of the passing of one of our life skills students who should be up on this stage. Her name was Addie Doyen Balaji. She was born in Nigeria and came to our program in 2004. I purposely requested to speak about her because when I first met her, I was impressed by her perseverance, her tenacity, and her sweet nature. She suffered with a genetic disorder called neurofibromatosis. This debilitating disorder primarily affects the nervous system by causing tumors to grow on your nerves. These tumors cause pressure damage to all the other nerves. For Doyen, the result was painful, difficult, and her daily routine could almost not be tolerated. However, as you can probably tell, Doyen was not your typical person. Her teacher described her as a loving, caring young lady who had a radiant smile that would light up a room. And I'm sure you saw her in some of the slides today. Even when in extreme pain, she would beg to stay in school and participate in the MBF Center studying basic computer and business. A determination that was wonderful to see, but difficult for her to bear. Following Doyen's passing, her teachers decided to create a memorial garden in her honor. That was the last slide. The angel was chosen as the centerpiece for the garden because, according to the teachers, her countenance was that of an angel. It wasn't until I viewed the angel that I knew Doyen stood for something far more significant than her existence here on Earth. When I decided to speak, I had to think about what I was going to say very carefully, not knowing this child for a very long time. And I wasn't able to get in touch with her mother. And so I decided what I usually decide to do when I'm at a loss for something to do, is I go to the internet. I don't know if you've ever Googled your name, but I have. I put my name in, and needless to say, I came back with a lot of stuff that was humorous, and some of it very creative. In this situation, I put in Doyens, thinking that I might get some insight. I placed it in the Google search function, and 536 hits came back. That, to me, was astounding. When I got through the first five pages, I came across a very interesting section. The 21st session of the International Poplar Commission popped up. This commission was jointly hosted by two countries, Canada and the United States. And in all, 25 countries participated, including Nigeria. A total of 258 delegates, advisors, and observers came from a number of different countries. When I got to the end of the report, there was Doyen's name. And the address was for the largest city in Nigeria, Ibanyan. The purpose of this conference was to discuss the genetic engineering programs, restitution of forest lands to their former owners, environmental issues and concerns, energy conservation, new regulations for forest reproduction material, and bioenergy as they pertain to the willow and the poplar tree. The report was 60 pages long, and as I said, there on the last page was a name I recognized. I can't help but ask myself, does this have something to do with the real Doyen? It wasn't Doyen's person who attended that conference. I know that. But I'd like to think that the angel in the garden signifies the spirit of this young woman who now cares for the willows and the poplars in places around the world. Then I will know that her life will continue to have meaning. Thank you.
This concludes the 2007 Special Needs Graduation Ceremony. Graduates will greet their guest in the auditorium lobby where there will be light refreshments. I do ask that the undergraduates stay in their seats until our graduates and guests have gone to the lobby. We will now recede to the lobby, the graduates will, and then the guests will please follow. Thank you.